Hey everybody, Jeff Bernhard, your executive gardener here. Hey, I want to give you an update on my lemon tree. So many of you probably saw an episode that I had probably 3, 4, or 5 episodes ago where I talked about this dwarf lemon tree. And it wasn't doing so good in the late summer, early fall. And then I hit it hard with compost tea. Hit it about once a week with really good compost tea, and it came back, and I'll show you a close-up here, but it produced some absolutely beautiful lemons. So, you know, I just wanted to talk about the lemon tree here. If you have dwarf lemon trees, you know, they're really easy to grow, and if you like lemons or you like limes, you'll see by this pot that I have behind me, it's probably a 25-gallon, 30-gallon pot, and this tree here is probably about 6, 7 years old. But it year after year it just keeps producing beautiful lemons for me. So just a few tricks of the trade. If you're producing lemons, typically you know they like to grow in warmer climates. So if you're in zones 8 to 10 from an agricultural zone, you're probably in the perfect place. Obviously they don't do well with frost, and the reason I'm showing you this video today, which is November 17th, 2014, is because tonight it's supposed to get down to 28 degrees, so I've got to get these things off the tree or I risk damage to the lemons. So just a few tips of the trade. So for those that don't know, lemon trees typically have to be 3 to 5 years old before they start producing fruit. And so if you have a 1-year-old, 2-year-old dwarf lemon tree like this is, don't be concerned about it if it doesn't. It takes about 3 to 5 years old. In addition to that, in the off season, you really want to fertilize it, I'd say once, probably good in the spring. But the most important nutrient to a lemon tree is phosphorus. So phosphorus produces the flowers and the buds, which actually turns to fruit. And without phosphorus, you just aren't going to get as plentiful of a production of a lemon, lemons on a lemon tree. So pay attention to your phosphorus, but go to your typical agricultural store, buy a balanced NPK fertilizer, put a good amount on in the early spring, maybe if you're coming out of winter in the summer zones, and then soak it in really good. The other thing when I hear from my subscribers that they don't get good fruit set on lemons is that you need to have a pot that has excellent drainage, okay? So the drainage has to be good, it has to be evenly, and it has to be often. So it shouldn't be sopping wet, but there should be a good amount of moisture throughout the plant at any one point in time, especially if you're in some of the hotter zones like Florida, Texas, Southern California, Arizona. They like a lot of liquid. And then the last thing I'd recommend to you, which has been my secret to my success, is compost tea. So what I typically do is once a week I brew up a batch of compost tea and I pour it into my plant, douse it really good. And between the N, the P, and the K, we talked about the P being potassium, being phosphorus, which is really the important part. It gives it a good balance of all the nutrients, in addition to some micronutrients that you'll find in compost tea. So compost tea, to me, has actually been the secret. And the great thing about these lemons is you can see the size of this lemon. It's extremely juicy. Compared to store-bought lemons that get picked prior to the point that they're ready, they're probably going to produce 2 to 3 times more juice and much more flavor. So the plan is to, and I'll show you a close-up here, I have probably about 25 lemons on this tree, and I have another lemon tree I'll show you, is to produce lots of lemonade and lemons for iced tea and so forth. So I'll show you a close-up of the lemon tree, what it looks like and what my production is. But looks like I got a good harvest this year. And again, if you're looking to grow a lemon tree or a fruit tree, I would go with a dwarf lemon tree. Very easy if you do the right things that I talked about in this video. So stay tuned. I'll show you a close-up here. I'll get behind the camera and show you what my 2 lemon trees look like. So I told you I'd get a good close-up of the lemon tree. Here's the one. You see it's not more than 2-3 feet tall, wide. The other thing I failed to mention is that as you look at your dwarf lemon tree like this one, pretty much in the winter, you may want to prune some of the branches that appear to be dead that fruit grew on last year. Pare it down really good. As I talked about in my earlier video, give it a look. I'm going to continue giving it compost tea throughout the winter. Some zones where you live, you're not going to be able to do that. I realize that, but make sure you hit it in the spring, like I talked about. So let's just take a look at this. Like most of these lemon plants, be careful, there's thorns in them. But you'll see, I mean, look at these, the brilliant color of each of these fruits. And they pretty much surround the entire tree. You'll see some there. And then a really nice fruit set there. There's one there. And a few that are back here, and even more here. So I probably have 25 or 30 of these lemons on this tree, but my kids and I will certainly enjoy making lemonade. Let me show you my second tree, which is planted in the ground. And I forgot to mention also that, you know, the plant will only get as large as the roots, and most of you know that, but that's why this tree is a dwarf tree, but it's not going to get any more than 2 or 3 feet. It's bound by the pot it's in. Let me show you the difference between my second dwarf lemon tree and what it looks like when the roots are allowed to expand in the earth, in the ground. So here's my second dwarf lemon tree. You can see this one at the top stands almost 6 feet, about 6 feet 5 inches. At the top, of course, I'll prune those branches off in the off season, the winter. Now, this tree did not produce as much fruit as my other one. I think part of the reason is I didn't fertilize it well enough with phosphorus. And some of the flowers that set dropped. So, of course, you don't have flowers, you don't have fruit. But what I did get, you'll see here, I'll try to get a close-up here, is I did get a good amount of fruit on here. Not as much as my little dwarf tree. It had about 25, but you know, I probably have about 10, 13 maybe on this. But interesting enough, these are actually bigger. Look at the size of this one here. Well, let me see if I can get closer. It's a bad shot, but compared to my hand, it's a fairly decent size lemon. But it did get lemons, as you see there, but not as much. So again, I think the secret here, excuse me, I keep hitting the microphone, is, you know, make sure I do a better job. So I assumed this was in the ground like this, and it was going to get the appropriate NPK. It just wasn't the case. I need to focus on my nutrients next year on this dwarf lemon tree. Again, when you get tall branches coming out like that, it's best to prune those off. I'm looking, and doing that, what that'll do, it'll train the tree to get wider versus higher. So I will prune those off in the winter and get these fruit off. Make sure, again, I'm actually going to use compost tea on this. I did not use compost tea on this, but I did the other one. That's part of the reason probably why I didn't get as good a fruit set. But the gardening's all about learning lessons and doing different next time. But pretty happy. This is, the other one's about a 6 or 7 year old tree. This is a 4 year old tree, but again, it's bigger because it's in the ground as opposed to in a pot. So this is my other dwarf lemon tree. And again, all in all, we probably have about 35 lemons from two little trees in the backyard. We'll hope to do better next year, but certainly a good crop for my small family in the backyard. Again, anybody can do this. Just send me a message or a comment if you have any questions about this. Most of you can pick up a dwarf lemon tree or lime tree at any Lowe's, Home Depot, or local garden center for 20, 30 bucks, and they will produce each year. And they do, if you've never smelled a bud or a flower from a lemon tree, they're just unbelievably delightful. So I hope you've enjoyed this quick session. This is the end of the season for the lemons here in Zone 8B, because we are getting frost tonight, and I am happy with my crop. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up or send it to a friend who's interested in getting into backyard gardening. We all learn from each other here on the Executive Gardener Channel. Until next time, have a great one.